All right, so we've looked at the process of lime and how we get it out of the quarry onto the land. And just going forward a step, what we want to do is getting it into your ideal optimum range and why we want to do that. So when you look at a soil test, you'll see that your optimum level should be somewhere between 5.8 and 6.2. And the reason for that is because that's when you get the greatest abundance of your major nutrients while not impacting on the animal health requirements that go through into the animal. So it's that happy medium that we have, and as we talked about earlier, pH is sort of the referee of the soil, so it says stop and go to plant nutrient availability. When you look at this, pH is really important for clover production, and one of those reasons why is because we've got this trace element in the soil, and it's required in the smallest amount, but it contributes the most to the clover. And the reason we're talking about here is molybdenum, or moly as it's referred to. What moly does is as your pH increases, your moly availability also increases. And moly is really important for the clover for nitrogen fixation. So with a lack of molybdenum, the chances are that you don't have the ability to fix nitrogen out of the atmosphere and turn it into plant available nitrogen in the clover, which the animal can eat and then urinate somewhere else in the paddock. And that's how you get your free nitrogen cycle happening in your pastoral system. So here we're looking at a pasture composition of ryegrass and clover. So there's some white clover, there's a little bit of red clover in here as well. And this clover and this pasture has just been chopped and it's going to get baled up this afternoon into baleage bales. Another awesome reason why we want to lift our pH is because we want to neutralise as far down into the soil profile as possible. So if we talk about the topsoil, that's your CBD, where you can go and you get a whole availability of nutrients, and then you go further down into the subsoil where there's a little bit less nutrient abundance and your pH starts to decrease. The thing with pH decreasing is that the roots don't like to go in down and take up heavy metals such as iron and aluminium. So the higher we can lift that pH into the optimum range, the further down the profile, the more ability you've got for rooting depth, which taps into water and nutrients as well. So if we're talking about New Zealand exports, we're talking about doubling the value that happens by 2050. And one of the main ways that we can do this is making sure that our soil fertility through herbage testing and soil testing, so getting that good base foundation is there, is allowing us to make sure that our soil fertility is in that optimum range. Specifically looking at pH, because as we talked about earlier, pH is really important and it's the referee of those nutrients in the soil. At the end of the day, every farmer wants to have as much yield as possible from every hectare of land. And so it's about optimising that and getting the most production that they can. For any more questions, make sure you pop into your PGG Wrightson store or go and talk to your local technical field rep.